ready?
Mm-hmm.
Do you?
Yeah.
It's not so windy today.
It's not so windy today. When we were first here, was it yesterday?
No, the day before.
2 days ago. It was much more windy. It was the windy day, and when the wind came back, because it's been so hot.
Yeah.
And not windy, which is unusual for Silas, really.
Yeah.
It's supposed to be windy.
Yeah. It was so windy that they had to delay the ferries and stuff. Yeah.
Yeah. So these beautiful big flowers, some of them had, or a lot of them had fallen down to the ground, and they were dancing around here in this street. And the sound of the leaves on the ground, I can't really. This is a nice one because this is drier. So it's quite a, like a dry
sound. It's like paper almost.
Yeah,
it's like paper.
Yeah,
basically.
But then we caught it, like, because there was so many, and they were, you know, being blown back and forth in the street by the wind, and making this like rustling, papery sound. The reason we find it interesting is because it's a natural element, sounding like something domestic maybe, or something that's man-made, or so we're looking for these sounds that can give you many different associations.
Yeah,
that's not so but it's not always so clear what exactly the sound source is.
Mm. So there's this blur between this like non-human, human sort of thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like organic, or is it organic, or is it man-made? Yeah. But these are really interesting, how they become like paper.
Mm-hmm. I mean, which would also happen to leaves.
Yeah.
So it's not like revolutionary.
But it's interesting.
They were so pretty with the
pink. But I think the way that the shape of them and the way that the wind must push them around has it like they kind of turn around and they have like three surfaces, so
yeah,
they make, I don't know, the way
they're
all
tumbling.
Is really